One of us was going to do it. Anyway, hi. Welcome to Monster Vlogs. I'm Charlie.
I'm Haley.
And we just saw the Wolfman. Starring Lon Chaney Jr., released in 1941 from Universal Pictures. Bunch of people. Credits here.
Claude Rains
is in it. Ralph Bellamy is in it. If you've ever seen Trading Places, he's the other Duke brother, not the one who voices the Golden Retriever in Homeward Bound. If you are 12, you don't know what I'm talking about. But anyway, you had your bride talk. It's time to have my Wolfman talk.
Please go ahead.
All right. The Bride of Frankenstein may be my favorite horror movie or favorite Universal monster movie. Wolfman is my favorite monster. And it's not because, you know, in Nightmares in Red, White, and Blue, he's called, you know, perpetual adolescence because it's just such
an odd place.
Obvious metaphor.
Can't control his hormones.
But, you know, it's just like that whole dual personality thing. Like, Jekyll and Hyde, it's the Hulk, it's Fight Club, it's all of these things. And I don't know why, like, even as a kid, like, I dressed up, like, okay, embarrassing moment here. Here's a bunch of pictures of me when I was the Wolf Man as a child.
Yeah. Baby Charlie.
Like, mm-hmm.
He's
just
so cute.
Before we actually begin the actual analysis of the Wolf Man, let's go over reasons why this works and Werewolf of London doesn't.
As we go over the plot.
Now, obviously, I'm a little clouded by nostalgia goggles and personal biases about the Wolfman being my favorite monster, so seeing him represented in such a way that didn't quite fit a supernatural mythos was kind of strange. And, you know, just looking at him, that's not a Wolfman. That's a bat.
Bat Yeti!
That's a Bat Yeti from the Himalayas.
Bat Yeti of London.
This Lon Chaney, I mean, despite not having a snout, it is still very much a werewolf.
That is the extent of makeup abilities at that time.
Which I can, fine. Growing up.
It's amazing.
Growing up,
like,
that
is the superlative.
Growing up, that was my Wolfman. That was a werewolf. Whenever I thought werewolf, boom, Lon Chaney Jr. Wolfman, 1941, Universal Monster. I didn't think American Werewolf in London, despite it being out at the time. I didn't think The Howling, despite it being out at the time, because I didn't know those movies. I knew about The Wolfman, and that's the image.
You didn't think Teen Wolf?
I did have Teen Wolf, but even that didn't really have much of a snout. That was more like 80s hair metal Wolfman. In fact, it was 80s hair metal Wolfman.
Van Howlin.
Seeing it now, I mean, I have tried to see it before, but I don't know, for some reason I kept falling asleep when I was, it was about like maybe 5 or 6 years ago that I tried to see it. But I can going through all the monster movies, I can appreciate like seeing all these actors, like Claude Rains in there opposite Lon Chaney Jr. as his father, which
his very short father
kind of didn't work, but
that was cool. They acted it well.
They act well. Like I said, it was more.
It was an estranged son and father.
Yeah,
and
it was more like
feel that.
It was more like they were business partners and not so much father and son.
And they, because the plot of the movie is Lon Chaney Jr.'s character had been away for 18 years, and he and his father were just then trying to reconnect and trying to have a relationship again when this happens.
Yeah, and it was after a hunting accident
that killed his older brother.
His older, presumably twin brother. Because if you pay it, like, that painting looked exactly like Lon Chaney Jr.
Interesting.
And another parallel that I drew from it, two brothers!
Connected by a wolf!
Romulus and Remus much? I love how this writer did his research.
Mm-hmm. Though technically Romulus and Remus suckled at the wolf's teat, so it would be interesting to speculate if the older brother was killed by a werewolf.
Well, the hunting accident you could presume was at the hands of his father. But anyway, he gets bit by a wolf and kind of goes throughout the entire movie that, oh,
sweet
he's...
cane.
Oh, I love that cane. That, let put a picture up of the cane. Boom.
Wolf's head cane.
Love this cane. I want to buy this cane. This cane will be in my possession after Magfest, probably during Magfest if
after
we can find it there.
After my sword cane.
But, okay. Now, throughout this movie, it's not quite clear whether Lon Chaney Jr. is crazy or not, because originally it was supposed to be more of a psychological film.
The audience was supposed to never know if it was all in his head or if he was actually a wolfman.
You weren't supposed to see a wolfman on screen at all.
The studio decided 2 weeks before filming that they can't have a monster movie without a monster, so they just made him a wolfman, but you can still see remnants of the whole psychological aspect.
Yeah, just kind of Lon Chaney Jr. like second-guessing himself, going around to everybody asking, do you believe in werewolves? Am I a werewolf? Look at the pentagram on my chest!
That's a scar. And, like, that whole thing. And then there's, like, the instigating factor is Bela Lugosi plays a bit character that turns into a werewolf and is attracting this girl.
Gee,
and Lon
Bela
Chaney...
Bela Lugosi turning into a wolf. Ooh, we haven't seen that before. Literally, we haven't.
You know, turning into a werewolf, attacking a girl, Lon Chaney Jr. comes to help out, and he kills the wolf, but later they find Bela Lugosi's body. So they're saying he killed a man, when in his memory, he's certain he killed a wolf. And that's like
crazy. Oh, but it was crazy. Everybody around you was talking about werewolves, you were just confused.
Why is everybody saying I'm the one confused?
I was there.
I killed the wolf with this sweet cane.
I love that cane.
Anyway, we were comparing it to Werewolf of London.
Okay, but there really is no comparison. This is the superior werewolf film.
Yes. The way Lon Chaney acts as the werewolf.
He's up on his, like, the balls of his feet so that it looks, resembles something canine.
He doesn't stop to get his hat and coat when he goes out the door. He jumps out the window like a proper wolfman.
Although he does magically have...
Magically go from wife beater to fully buttoned up shirt.
Mm.
I considered that his Hulk pants.
Okay. That they just magically turn purple.
You know, that the real reason is they couldn't do the makeup all the way up his arms, but those are his magical Hulk outfit.
Yeah.
I liked the Roma woman. She was so lovely.
She's so the whole
sweet.
Reason I love this movie.
She's like the whole heart of the movie, because she's the one that's like looking after all the werewolf
she
boys.
She is so mythic. Oh, like, I love her. I love the just
she
the,
is Baba Yaga and Sarah Dwin and Morgan Le Fay
the
and
mystique
like all these
around her is just ooh. You could tell she is like this powerful. She's not necessarily a powerful supernatural being. She has just seen some stuff. Like, and she has that wisdom of the ages mm-hmm. that just carries in her face and her eyes and just her stance and everything. That woman really acted that part well.
Yes, she did.
And just
so
how she
well
looks
done.
Up at, well, I mean, obviously you have to look up at Lon Chaney Jr. Giant of a man. And just looks up at him and says, and now go and heaven help you. That, oof. Gives me goosebumps every time. It's such a good movie. Number two to Bride of Frankenstein. I'm knocking Old Dark House out to number three.
Somewhere after Dracula's Daughter for me.
Okay. What did you think? I've done all the talking. What did you think?
I really enjoyed it. I liked the psychological aspect, and I really wish they'd gone with more of it. Because when it was, you know, as much as I love Jack Pierce's makeup, and I did, the psychological aspect would have definitely held my attention better.
Yeah.
That's what held my attention through the whole thing. I loved Claude Rains in this. He was so sympathetic and understanding and just, you know, wanted to do right by his son, even though he didn't know him that well.
And just that whole conversation with her, the woman and him, like, in the forest toward the end, was like, oh, you have second doubts. I want to go with my son. So you want to see if he's all right? You had doubts? You believe?
It was such a well-shot film.
Oh man, there's a couple shots that need to be submitted to One Perfect, Shot. Follow that Twitter, by the way.
Yes, it's a rockin' awesome Twitter.
It is.
Put it on the screen.
It is DP porn. It is like if you are.
You're studying composition, like study composition. Like go
and
follow One Perfect Shot, and then look up, you know, classic paintings.
Oh yeah, and then there's, but then there's like this one shot. Like there's a couple really good shots. There's one in the church, the where you could just see everybody coming in, and you know, I just said like freeze frame any of these and submit them.
So well lit, but so then there's beautifully
the,
done.
Then there's the one in the crypt where the old woman comes up to the, well, even then, you know, Lon Chaney Jr. comes up to the coffin or the mm-hmm. the casket,
and then the
opens
woman
it up,
does.
And then the woman does. But it's framed in such a way where it's nearly symmetrical.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's just a little off-center.
It's a bit asymmetrical.
It's just...
And I think, if I remember correctly, Lon Chaney Jr. was more asymmetrical than the woman was. Which would make sense from screen psychology.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just to show that there's something a little
he is
off
more
about her.
Mm-hmm.
He's a little off-center from everybody else. Ugh. All right, we're done gushing about this movie. Are you done gushing?
I very much enjoyed it more than Werewolf of London.
I mean, obviously, Werewolf of London has a cult following, as you can
apparently
see in our comment section. Mm-hmm. But
Wolfman was better.
Wolfman is the superior. There is a reason.
It's called the first good werewolf film.
Well, not only the first good werewolf film, but the first like.
Definitive
monster movie since about Invisible Man. Well, I mean, there really hasn't been a staple since Invisible Man
right.
or Invisible Man Returns.
Like a new monster.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And, you know, this movie definitely proved to Universal that Lon Chaney Jr. is worth keeping around, and we're going to see a whole lot more of that.
The one Universal monster never to be recast.
Mm-hmm.
Because Lon Chaney Jr. played it so well.
And he also holds the distinction of playing one, like, every single one
of the top tier
Universal monsters. He plays a vampire in Son of Dracula. He plays the monster in the next movie that we're going to see, Ghost of Frankenstein. He plays the Wolfman, and he plays the Mummy.
From here on out.
Mm-hmm. And all the bad Mummy movies.
And all of his whiteness.
But. What did you draw today, dear?
Well, inspired, I started looking up reference pictures for The Wolf and Nameless Woman Who Has Some Sort of Connection to The Wolf.
Very cool.
Thank you.
I will put it up on screen. Okay. Horrifying in 1941. Horrifying now.
Were you horrified?
I was more giddy about this. Just like that, after that first transformation scene, I was just like, okay, where's my guy? Where's my guy? I was a puppy.
Oh.
Oh. All right. But
it was intriguing.
Oh, totally.
I can't say my pants were scared off, but it was very intriguing.
I really love the psychological aspect
yes,
of it.
Yes, like, that was my favorite part of it, actually.
That is probably the only part of this that's a little bit timeless. Because, I mean, makeup effects kind of age over time, and while this is a very timeless design, it has obviously been outdone.
Right. Howling case in point.
American Werewolf in London. You cannot beat that transformation scene.
Mm.
And even, you know, it was even outdone by Stan Winston in a movie that hopefully Nostalgia Critic is going to be reviewing next Tuesday. Anyway. If you enjoyed this video, by all means, like, comment, subscribe.
Howl at us in the comments section.
Bark at the comments. Arr.
Arr,
arr, arr, arr. I'm not translating. I didn't translate it before. But.
Like, subscribe. Patreon. Patreon.
Would you stop that?
Nope.
Can I put a little moon in the Patreon? Like, put a little moon behind the Patreon and have it talk. Ha, I'm the moon. Give us money.
Watch our other videos.
We got videos for days.
Last video is...
What was the last video?
Last video was...
It wasn't Hocus Pocus. Man-made monster. Okay.
That'd be over there, isn't it? Over there.
Over there? I mean, we're just sandwiched by Lon Chaney Jr. We got boom, boom, and then Ghost of Frankenstein.
It's a Chaney sandwich.
Well, I could actually go for a sandwich right now.
I could go for an ice cream sandwich.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, next time...
Ghost of Frankenstein.
Ghost of Frankenstein.
Man who says his prayers at night when the wolf mane...
Will still become a wolf when the wolf fane blooms and the August moon is bright.
It's autumn.
Autumn moon. Autumn. Same difference. August starts...
Look, honey, I know you've been living in California for just a little bit, but you know for a fact August ain't autumn. Okay, bye, everybody.
Rawr!
Ow!
Oh, are you okay? Are you okay, honey?
I was trying to be scary. Okay, bye.